everyone, I'm Sal, co-creator of Salt and Pepper Productions, and I'm back with another Danganronpa video. Most of the students attending Hope's Peak Academy are very passionate about their talents, but there are a few students who disdain or have mixed feelings about their talents. Leon Kuwata, the ultimate baseball star, is the most obvious example. When we meet him in the first game, he tells us upfront that he doesn't like baseball and that he plans to become a musician. Even though Leon hates his talent and wants nothing to do with it, his talent is a huge part of who he is as a person. He can't escape from it. In fact, he depends on it. In his final free time event, Leon tells Makoto Naegi that he's starting to miss playing baseball, even though he's always hated the sport. He tells Makoto, "It's like mind control. Baseball brainwashed me." Or, "It's control in my mind. I've been brainwashed," depending on the translation. This suggests that he feels like he can't get away from baseball because he was forced to play for so long. Whether he likes it or not, baseball is a huge part of Leon's life, and he feels weird being away from it. After killing Sayaka Maizono in the main story, Leon uses his pitching skills to dispose of the bloody evidence. This shows us that even though he doesn't like baseball, he depends on it. Yuto Kamishiro is another student who has a complicated relationship with his talent. Yuto is the ultimate spy. Throughout Danganronpa Zero, he uses his talent to investigate the student council killing game. In Volume 2, he tells Ryoko Otonashi that his talent restricts him. It forces him to stay on a specific path in life. But during that same conversation, he states that his talent is all he has. He keeps putting so much emphasis on his ultimate spy talent because, in his mind, he'd be nothing without it. In Danganronpa 3, Despair Arc Episode 1, Chiaki Nanami tells Hajime Hinata that he has more freedom than her because he isn't bound to a talent. This concept, being a slave to your own talent, definitely applies to Leon and Yuto, but the most significant character this concept applies to is Junko Enoshima. Most know Junko as the ultimate fascination, but she's also the ultimate analyst. Her analytical talent allows her to predict events and behaviors. It's a much more accurate version of what Yasuhiro Hagakure does. Instead of staring into a crystal ball and pulling random predictions out of thin air, she makes them based on her surroundings, based on observation. In Danganronpa 3, Despair Arc Episode 6, Junko tells Izuru Kamakura about her analytical talent and states that it's the reason why she finds everything, besides despair, boring. It's possible Junko hated her talent growing up, similar to how Leon hated playing baseball. Young Junko probably believed that her life was both meaningless and unsatisfying. I believe she felt this way because she had no passion, nothing excited her. Many Danganronpa characters are very passionate about their unique skills, but Junko wasn't passionate about her own skill. In fact, she believed it made her life boring and predictable. It's interesting to compare Junko to the protagonists of the series. First, there's Makoto, a teenage boy who has no talent and seems to be okay with that. So much so that whenever someone calls him the ultimate hope and treats him like he's special, he pushes back. Then there's Hajime, a teenage boy who has no talent but wants a talent so bad, he lets Hope's Peak Academy perform experiments on him. Then there's Kumaro Naegi, a teenage girl who has no talent and feels like she can't accomplish anything. Then there's Junko, the series' main antagonist. Unlike the main protagonist, Junko has a talent, a very impressive talent, but she's not happy. In fact, she believes her talent is the source of her unhappiness. It's possible Junko's hatred for Hope is connected to her hatred for her own talent. Remember, Hope's Peak Academy is a well-known, well-regarded school, and the people running the school truly believe that talent equals hope. Junko probably heard about Hope's Peak Academy and its philosophy at a very young age and began to perceive Hope as boring and unsatisfying. At some point in her life, Junko discovered that she's a sadomasochist. She discovered that pain and despair, regardless of whether it's her own pain or another person's pain, excited her. She began to use chaos, pain, and despair as a way of escaping from her boring, unsatisfying life. Her sadomasochistic tendencies turned into a hobby. This hobby turned into an obsession, and this obsession eventually became a huge part of who Junko Enoshima is as a person. In 2016, Weeby Newz uploaded a Junko character analysis video. In that video, she talks about Junko's boredom and suggests that it's linked to her possessing multiple talents. Some of the examples she cited in the video were Junko's sandcastle building skills, something we learned from Yasuke Matsuda in the first volume of Danganronpa Zero, the creation of the Junko / Monokuma AI, and, of course, Junko's analytical talent. Now, I don't agree with everything Weeby Newz said in this part of the video. Personally, I don't think it's probable that Junko created the AI herself, and Danganronpa 3 specified that her analytical talent was the cause of her boredom. Still, Weeby Newz's many hobbies, many talents observation got me thinking. Maybe young Junko tried to discover her passion by experimenting with different activities to see if she could find something that thrilled or excited her. Maybe the sandcastle building phase was one of those experiments. Maybe young Junko experimented with computers, got frustrated, and gave up. Maybe her fashion gig was just another failed experiment. There are two interesting Junko Mukuro scenes in Danganronpa 3 Despair Arc Episode 5. When Junko picks her sister up at the airport, she's journaling. She's narrating everything that happens around her, and she continues to do this the following morning. Mukuro even makes a couple remarks about it. Most people probably see these scenes as nothing more than goofy fourth wall breaking moments. But I think these scenes actually support the idea that Junko spent a lot of time experimenting with different activities in an attempt to discover her passion and escape from her analytical talent. Note Mukuro's dialogue. So, narration's your current obsession, Junko? This seems to imply that it's typical of Junko to try a new hobby, get bored, abandon it altogether, and then move on to the next thing. Now, we know that Junko is plotting the destruction of Hope's Peak Academy in this scene, so it's interesting to see that, even at this point in her life, she's still trying to find her passion. She's still trying to find a hobby that thrills and excites her more than despair. Ultimately, she felt that narrating wasn't something that thrilled her, so she decided to go through with her plan. Even though Junko discovered satisfaction through despair, she didn't completely escape from her analytical talent. Similar to Leon and Yuto, Junko is forced to use and rely on her talent throughout the series. If you've read Danganronpa Zero, you know that Ryoko is actually Junko suffering from amnesia. This conversation with Yuto takes place towards the end of Volume 2, not too long before Junko recovers all her memories. Ryoko / Junko is silent throughout most of the conversation, but her narration tells us that she understands the love-hate relationship Yuto has with his talent. Maybe Ryoko / Junko agrees with his sentiment because she, subconsciously, feels the same way about her own talent. She detests it, but she also trusts and relies on it. She views it as a necessity. She needs to observe and analyze her surroundings. She needs to learn about the people around her. She needs to study and understand everyone so she can find the best ways to use and manipulate them to get them to do what she wants or needs them to do. It's interesting because, as I said before, the people running Hope's Peak Academy idolize talent. It's ironic, if not poetic, that Junko took the talent they love oh so much and used it against them. It mirrors her actions in Trigger Happy Havoc. When Junko erased her classmates' memories, she gave them hope, i.e., the desire to leave. She used that hope to start the killing game, which caused despair among the students and despair among everyone who was watching the broadcast. The higher-ups at Hope's Peak Academy believe that talent is the equivalent of hope. Junko used the world's most talented people, the world's greatest hopes, to start the tragedy and create widespread despair. In summary, Junko is a villain because she was born with a talent she hated into a society that idolized talent and hope. She sought refuge through despair, became obsessed, and decided to dedicate her life to painting the world with despair, starting with the destruction of Hope's Peak Academy. To achieve her goal, she, like Leon and Yuto, is forced to use and rely on the talent she hates so much. Thank you for watching the video. So, what are your thoughts on Junko and her analytical talent? What are your thoughts on Leon and his talent, or Yuto and his talent? Are there other characters who have love-hate relationships with their talents? Do you agree or disagree with anything I had to say in the video? Let us know in the comments below. Don't be afraid to like and subscribe. Check out our other videos. If you haven't already, be sure to share this video. And hopefully we'll see you again soon. Bye!